Of recent, insofar as her gold-digging career was concerned, Melody had ambitious designs on winning the affections of a certain well-fixed justice who presided over the imperial courthouse in downtown Pimpleton. Although she had neither as yet caught sight of nor bemet the aforetold nabob, she had heard intriguing first-hand accounts aplenty apropos of his quick-witted exploits in the courtroom. She planned on making his acquaintance as soon as she was able to prearrange an unqualifiedly propitious set of circumstances wherein to do so, for she knew it was important to make a favorable first impression upon a man of such formidable means and reputation. This particular justice was rumored to be a multi-gazillion heir who owned a massive empire of upscale, high-end, over-the-top real estate, i.e., castles, chateaus, alcazars, palazzi, converted cathedrals, thousand-story skyscrapers, Colosseum-sized condominiums, orbiting satellite casinos, etc., etc. Ergo, one might not be overly far afield in characterizing this man as a slumlord of sorts for the super-rich. Melody's road dog, Angelique, had briefed her about Judge O'Nance and had promised to introduce her to him in the not-too-distant future. Ah, but well-a-day! For little did poor Melody, our mollycoddled young demigoddess, imagine, in her wildest incubi, how this long-awaited rendezvous with the man of her dreams was forepointed to play out.